You know what almost killed the Batman franchise? George Clooney. But anyway, hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee, we're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. But anyway, as we make our way across this little tight bridge, we are still in Terrydactyland. In the last part, we took down the boss of this world, and then we found out she's actually a good guy. Or a good girl, to be exact, because we found out she's a parent, and we have to eventually hatch all our eggs and get another Jiggy from her. But anyway, what I wanted to show off is, as you make your way to the top, hey, that wasn't, okay, let's not try anything too fancy. As you make your way up to the mountainside, to Terry, you can actually get some health right here. If you were taking some hits from her mucus attacks, yeah, it makes it a little easier. I know it's a part late, but wanted to show it off anyway. But anyway, we are in the bonfire cavern, and like I showed off before, we can use the ice eggs not only to freeze enemies, but to douse flames as well. And we actually have to watch out for these little pterodactyl-like enemies again, because they can hit us off the side, and that will not be a fun time. But did anyone else like that little joke I made in the beginning, by the way? I know it would have been incredibly easy to make a Dr. Freeze joke with Arnold Schwarzenegger, but you know what? I took the high road. I took the high road and I was a little original. Probably was a lame-ass joke, but still, I'm going to go with it. But anyway, so we see over here there's some swap pads for Banjo and Kazooie. I wonder if we'll be using them both. Probably so, but as we make our way over here, we see we see some footprints in the ground. Those look like pretty big footprints, to be exact. Wonder if it's from a dinosaur, but yeah, it probably is. And as we can hear from the boss music, oh god, this isn't good. How are we gonna get crossed over there? I guess we'll find out, right? So there it is, the Stomponodon, Triassic Steamroller. I didn't read about that dinosaur in my textbooks, but it must be a new species. I heard recently, actually, that the Bronchiosaurus, the one with the long neck, is not actually a dinosaur anymore, so that may be kind of sad. I don't know, maybe there was such a thing as a Stompodon back in the day. How would they know? It was like 20 million years ago. But anyway, there are two ways to get over here for the time being, with Kazooie and with Banjo and Kazooie. With Banjo and Kazooie, we can make our way over here with the Wonder Wing. Yes, it's actually getting some use, finally. And if we go to the right, there's the Banjo and Kazooie little pad. And we will get a Jiggy, so yeah, it's actually pretty useful. It's our little Starman this game. But anyway, so we got the Jiggy there. What we want to do now is use the swap pads. This will slide us back to the beginning, by the way. And we will all go across with just Kazooie. I know that seems a little harsh and a little suicidal, but I think we can do it. I think we can do it. She's just fast enough for us to retreat in each of his footprints, so there we go. And if you run out of golden feathers, there's some of his footprints right here, so he's kind enough for that. Okay, that was a little close. And basically, if he stomps you, Raleigh should have mentioned this, you will go down to one health and two hits, and basically you're dead. So you really got to be careful with this guy. And with Kazooie, like I said before, it's relatively easy. And it was just the only thing you can't get across with is just Banjo for the time being. So we'll be learning a move in the next world, actually, that will solve that problem. And let's actually go up here and make our way back with Kazooie and reunite with Banjo, and we are done for now with the Stomping Plains. We will return here with Banjo at probably in another part or two, so for the time being, let's go back to the world entry and exit, and actually, let's actually go inside the mountain. We haven't done that yet, so let's see, let's just go into this main area right here. I don't know how we missed this the first time as we entered the world, but okay, that's probably why there's a gate. Okay, let's see if we can go up to the side of the gate, and let's see if we can actually get into this, because inside the mountain is actually, it's worth exploring, because there's a Jiggy in there, so this will actually take us, okay, this will take us to where that Rockna guy was. If you weren't clever enough to shoot a clockwork egg, then, yeah, that's how you get up there. But anyway, this is what I wanted to do. I wanted to grab onto this vine hidden in this waterfall right here. Just grab onto it and make our way up. Actually, I was going to show up behind us. There is one of the eggs that we have to hatch, but I'll be doing that a little later. But first, I want to go up this waterfall and enter the waterfall cavern. I believe that's what it's called. Am I right? It is called the River Passage. Okay, a little off. But then again, waterfall, cavern, kind of would have made that connection. Surprised it wasn't named that. But yes, we want to get that empty honeycomb right there. Let's shoot a clockwork egg over there. And, okay, we missed. Just missed a little to the right. Let's try again. But yeah, the significance of this area is that Banjo will be learning a new move. There we go. Got it. That's 5 empty honeycombs. I believe we need one more to get another piece of life. Or I think it's 7 now, actually. Because it was 6 the last time we went. So we'll be definitely visiting Honey Bee probably by the end of this world. And yeah, like I was saying, the importance of the River Passage is that we'll be learning a new move with Banjo, which is actually a pretty useful one. I think it is actually, yeah, we'll be using it to do something later in this part. To be exact, and we gotta watch these electric eels. They make a return from the last world. Just gotta avoid them, and there's 4 little nests of notes right here that we just gotta pick up, and there's the last one right there. And yeah, for some reason, when I would always play this on, like, back in the day in the N64. Okay, you gotta watch out for those guys. It's just, it's a really dark area, so you might have to adjust your TV settings here, but for now, I'm pretty good right now. I have my TV set to its optimal settings and brightness, so I'm pretty good now. Wish I had this kind of TV back in the day, but then again, LEDs did not exist in 2001. We had those big clunky ones with the big things in the back. Don't know what was in those big things, but they weren't of good quality, that's for sure. And yeah, so we got another stop pad right there, swap pad to be exact, and I saw a sign. Let's actually read it, see if it's anything important. It's exciting in the Oogle and Unga Caves. Oh, what a terrible pun. But, yes, we want to make our way over here with Banjo. Grab onto here. We can't attack this thing because normally we would have Kazooie with us by doing this, but it's just Banjo right now, so we gotta be extra careful. If we fall off, we gotta do the whole thing over again. And let's just drop down with B. And just shimmy over, get him out of there, and there we go. Okay, good. We're unscathed in that little wall climb, and there we go. We have enough notes to learn a taxi pack. No, Kazooie means space in your pack. A way to fill is what you lack. Pick large up things up above the ground, and there you go, and carry them around. Thank you, Wii Army. Now we all, and dismissed. You hit your head? No, you did not. Oh, that would have been funny if you did, though. But anyway, now that we have our new move, we can actually, if you hold down LT if you're playing on the Xbox 360 version, and hit right, or left, I'm sorry, with your right trigger stick. There we go. Banjo can now put things in his pack other than Kazooie. Pretty cool right here. I just love this. That thing about this game, I just love it for its idea to, like, make Banjo and Kazooie their own separate characters and they learn their own moves. I don't know. I thought that was really cool, this game. But I probably mentioned that countless times throughout this Let's Play. But then again, my memory is awful, especially when I'm doing a Let's Play. I have no idea what I said 10 parts ago. And I don't really watch my videos again, so yeah, what you're hearing is just my thoughts at the moment. So now that we know that new move, let's actually make our way out of the cave and do what we want, do what that move is intended to do, and actually pick up something. Pick up something that we saw back in Witchy World. I just love the attention to detail in this world, by the way. Got like little shrimp and fish right here. I don't know, they really did not have to add that, but just gives a little prehistoric feel of this world. And like I mentioned as we entered the world, this world is okay, buddy. I'm not really liking this part, and I can see why. Wait, is something under there? Did I see something, or am I crazy? Okay, probably crazy. But yeah, this world is really smart. It's really well planned out. The it's just that everything has a great rhyme or reason. It's just really hard to explain, too. That's the thing. It's just really clever, especially a lot of puzzles in this world revolve around the clockwork eggs, and we just learn them outside the world, and they're just great introducing that new move, and arc, but all go shape of the pair, but still 3 of us left. I really love that catchphrase. If you're gonna kill the next 3, and they're all gonna pretty much say that, so expect that to be her said a lot, and I don't really get the expression, and that's probably the point, so yeah, those guys are pretty weird, and they should probably cover up their asses, by the way. That's a big design flaw in their armor, but we'll take full advantage of that and claim a Jiggy by killing 3 more of them. And what we want to do right now is actually, we want to go by the world entry and exit. What I want to do is actually, like I said before, show off that new move. So we want to go right of the entrance and actually go to the, oh yeah, I have to get, okay, I didn't do that yet, did I? I actually passed it up. I should have done that on my way here, but I forgot. So let me just go back to outside Wumba's wigwam. Might as well explain what Wumba is in this world. Basically, you see a Mumbo pad right here. we have two transformations in this world, all thanks to Mumbo. When he uses his magic, he can turn the wigwam either big or small. Right now it's in a small setting, but it can get bigger than that. And as you can tell, that actually has a positive effect on our transformations, or has a direct effect on our transformations, so just know that.
So before we head to the train station, we're actually going to visit a certain dinosaur family. No, not the one from the hit TV show Dinosaur, which I used to watch a lot as a kid. I'm the baby, gotta love it. Oh my god, don't get me into that. But anyway, we are about to go and visit that because they obviously hold a cheeky for us, so that gives us the incentive to pay them a visit, just like it gives me the incentive to visit my grandparents because they give me money. Okay. That was a bit mean, and that guy looks a bit mean too, so I'll just shimmy on over past him, and, yes, there's a family cave of a bunch of dinosaurs. They have a split pad over here. I believe this uncovers a shop pad, which we'll use Kazooie on, because if we just go to Kazooie and switch over back to her, we can actually get, I think, an empty honeycomb. Let's just see if my premonitions were correct, and they were awesome. Alright, so she's getting a lot of use and stretching her legs out, just like a Jolly Rogers, and let's make our way up here and see what the problem is. There's only one dinosaur here, I think they're missing some. Go away, leave Scrawny alone. Why are you so sad? My family isn't keeping too well. Let's hear all the problems you want me to fix. Aw, look at my eldest Scrat, he's very sickly and needs a doctor urgently. Oh, I know a doctor. A witch doctor, to be exact. A witch doctor. Great joke. I don't care. Any doctor will do. I've heard there's a crazy shaman that lives on the clifftop who might help. That's why he's over there. Skrit here was out walking one day and came back this size. Now he's too small to be a proper dinosaur. And, okay, you got a sack of hay for a daughter. Skrit has gone missing too. She took some money from my purse and headed off to the train station. So many problems. More money, more problems. I told you so, Banjo. We'll see what we can do. I guess we will. Wonderful. It's nice to know not every character in this game is bad. Fourth wall breaking. But yeah, basically, this guy's a little too small to be a dinosaur, so to fix that, we're gonna get Mumbo over here and we're gonna supersize him. Not take him to McDonald's, but we'll give him some magic. Some steroids. Okay, it's magic. And that little dinosaur is sick. We have to actually use a sack pack to take it to the train station, which we can actually, I think I can actually do that now. I'm worried if that will affect the, getting the other dinosaur back from the train station, but I guess we'll try. It's worth a shot, I guess. So Banjo's gonna be doing some solo work right here. Oh god, run away. Run away from the psychotic honeycomb stack of honeycombs. Alright, so the train station is over yonder, not too far away. I wish they put a warp head actually in the family cave, but you know, it's just a stone's throw away. Oh, wow, that's a really old saying. I don't know why that just came up, I guess because it's a prehistoric kind of thing, but whatevs, whatevs. But anyway, so yeah, that is not a Jinjo. We will not go toward you, good sir. And there's a rock now. We can kill you with Kazoo later, but we don't have her. And let's go to the train thing and bring it back here. And Chuffy's enjoying the attractions of Witchy World. And would you like Chuffy to pick you up? Yes, we would. Remember, we put that certain dinosaur in that train in Witchy World. Now we're going to take her home. So that little side quest is becoming full circle right now. And there's a rhyme and reason saving that dinosaur from that attraction. So that solves one out of the three troubles, I guess, that family had. For some reason, I thought we had to pick her up and bring her there, but no, she just runs out, and I think my stay will be confirmed by this cutscene right here, which... Come on. Come on. And Jinjo, stop taunting me with your whistling. You're not a real Jinjo. You're a Binjo. You're a monster. And there we go. I hope Mom won't be too mad at me. Well, you were gone, what, a week? Well, I guess between my recordings, you've gone a couple months, but okay. Aw, now she's going faster. I love how they have little eyelashes, too, to, like, give them some character, I guess. Or show it's a girl, I don't know. And there we go. Thanks for returning my boss child. She'll be cleaning out our cave for the next month as punishment. Ugh. Cleaning out the room can always be a punishment, but you know what? For me, it just takes a couple minutes to just throw everything into a bag and just put it off to the side. That's the right way, right? I guess we'll meet up with Kazooie in there. Actually, no. Oh, what I wanted. Oh my god, I totally blew that. Oh my grr. What I wanted, that's why I came as Banjo. What am I, what an idiot I am. Basically what I wanted to do is sack pack the, oh god, I'm gonna stop right there before that sounds too wrong, but I wanted to take the sickly dinosaur to the train, and I forgot to do that, so bringing Banjo to the train station was utterly useless. And that's fantastic. Alright, looks like we'll have to do some editing here, and I'll be back in the cave with Banjo with the dinosaur in my backpack in hand, or in back. So I'll just see you in just a second. But first, since we're Kazooie right now, let's actually get this clockwork egg. Is there a hole over here? Nope, I guess we have to just freestyle and just shoot above him and hopefully it'll land perfectly. And yes, it does. Perfect. I'm gonna just get him in the butt, and there we go! Our Golgo shape of the pair! But still, two of us left. Oh god, that catchphrase is... Was that trying to sell, like, toys or whatever? There's Banjo right there. Let's reunite, and I'll be back once again when I get Banjo back in here with that dinosaur. I'll get back to the cave and then show that off. I'm not gonna cut that out, so I'll cut this part out. Alright, so let's officially swap back, and let's do this right. Wow, that really cost me a couple minutes in the recording sesh, but you know what? What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? And, he's over here, or she's over here. Let's just get the sack out. And you're mine! Banjo the kidnapping. He's abducting children, he's climbing in your caves, snatching your dinosaurs up. But anyway, now we're going to the train station, and this would have been amazingly well done and a great use of time, but unfortunately my brain noodle was too dumb to make the connection and realized that I did not pick up the dinosaur before heading out to the train station. So unfortunately we're going to take a couple of minutes out of the old video and do this, but you know what, editing's always fun and whatnot, so no problem. At this rate, it should be four parts anyway in this world, so I'm not too disappointed. So what we want to do is actually take the dinosaur in our backpack to the back of the train. We actually can go inside of it, and we're going to release it now. And inside Chuffy's wagon, and there we go! I pulled the dinosaur not out of my hat, but out of my backpack, and let's just talk. Oh, I'm still feeling rather rough. Is this train going to a doctor? Yeah, basically. Actually, never mind. I was gonna read the sign. But anyway, yes, basically we could take this train back to the cliff, and that's why Mumbo's at the cliff. He's outside of the world for a reason. Just like Wumba is, but we'll be seeing that much later. Much later. That'll be fun. But yeah, there is a reason why Mumbo is outside of the world, and just for that one reason is to heal that sick dinosaur, so oh, that's a pain in the ass right there. I keep forgetting. God. Alright, I'll be back with Banjo and Kazooie in just a second. I really forget to, like, just join them in the magical stuff. But anyway, we'll be right back. Alright, now that we've done that, what do we want to do? Do we actually want to go for another Jiggy right now? I'm really trying to think right here. Actually, let's go over here and, get this Jinjo and get this Rock Nut, because the one Jiggy I want to show off is a pretty cool little mini-boss, and I don't think I'm going to have enough time to fit it in this one, so we'll just solve this little puzzle right here and get it out of the way. Basically, there's a series of holes we can go in with the Clockwork Egg, and as we have a time limit, we gotta make this decision fast, and there we go, right to the Rock Nut. And basically, now there's only one left, super, and let's try over there now. Let's get this Jinjo. Let's enter you, and let's see, let's try to go left this time, if there is an opening to the left. I don't think there is, so okay, let's go back. We're running out of time, though. Gotta make haste, not waste. Let's try this hole. Okay, we can't go in that hole. Crap, running out of time. I'm coming, Jinjo! Am I in? No, I'm not. No, Banjo, I want to explore next to you! Yeah, because you actually can't hurt Banjo and Kazooie, so you just gotta be careful there. Let's try this hole. I wonder if I already tried. It's pretty confusing to get to these, oh, there he goes. It's not confusing to get to these Jinjos. And let's just blow up, and you served a good purpose, little Kazooie bomb. You've done well, my son, okay? Yes, all those are Kazooie's children. We got the spring shoes right here because, as we saw when Terry was, being nice to us, she released a fly pad, which you can access up here, which makes getting around the world 10 times easier. And let's just do that. And let's actually go for another Jinjo, which is by the entrance, which we can do by flying. Let's see if I can actually hit it with the Let's see. Where's the switch? Okay, it's back there. Whoops. Whoopsie. That's pretty cool entrance right there. Let me try using a grenade egg. I think I could do this already with that. Actually, no, I couldn't. There we go. Now I can do it while I'm midair. I would have had to go back to the fly pad to get this ginger, but now while I'm in midair, I can just go for it now. And you're mine! Perfect. Well timed, well timed. There's 4 out of 6 red Jinjos, I believe. And is it time to end the part yet? No, we're gonna go for some. You know what? I'm gonna take this opportunity to get all like the little stuff in this world, because that's what I've been doing for like the last couple minutes now. So I might as well keep up the pace. And I believe we can get something on here. Let's just do the talent torpedo. This should be Kazooie's face. Yep. There we go. Hit the switch. And there we go, another Jinjo. I can never tell. There's a brown and an orange Jinjo family in this game. Don't know why they picked two Jinjo types of similar colors, because it can get really confusing. And there we go, cool. The brown Jinjo family, that's it, yeah. Is now complete. Okay, there we go, 43 jigs. All right. Pretty awesome. But anyway, what do we want to do now is get that empty honeycomb by walking with a certain pair of shoes. Like a certain biblical figure, and it's right here. There we go. So basically, we'll just use these little guys from the last game. Ah, nostalgic. I haven't seen these in a while. And we can walk on water. Yeah, they're using this game is really about walking on water, above more than anything else. It's not really using any kind of race except in the last world, which we'll be getting to. Not one of my favorites, but. Oh well, so yes, we did that, and what else? We just, you wanna make our way to Mumbo, then end the port? I think that's a good idea. I think that is a well idea. A swell idea. Okay, okay, I got a little, physics boost, or not boost right there. As you can see, there's a picture of a certain, dinosaur. I wonder if we're gonna transform into that. Probably so, and, let's see, up there, I think there's something. But first, let's make our way over with the waiting boots, and then we'll get that. Then we'll end the part in front of Mumbo's. So, there we go, perfect. See, I think there's actually a Cheeto page over there, so. Yeah, we'll get that, and then we'll end the part. This part, I wonder how long it's gonna be, because I got edited quite a bit, and, we'll see what happens, I guess. And, let's just go over here and see what is over here. Just shimmy and just watch out for this trap. But yeah, we got pretty much all the little knickknacks we can get in this world. And the next part we'll probably be doing a little bit more. We'll be tackling a boss, that's for one. There's a lot of bosses in this world I've noticed. I think there's about 4? Like, in terms of like cutscene description, there's like 4 in this world. That's pretty awesome. And yep, the Cheeto page. And you know what, I'll just jump in the gook. I'll take the 1 damage that'll give me. I always ignore the waiting boots anyway and just go over here manually, so. It only takes 1 damage, it's not like you're just gonna sink like quicksand, so. Yeah, no consequence really. And then we get a warp head, and behind the hut is a globo. And I think we'll end it here, so thank you guys for watching. If you like this part, be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. It helps out my channel immensely, and it tells me how I'm doing and how I can better each part for you guys and make it that much more enjoyable. So I'll see you later, guys, until next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. We'll be taking out more of Terrydactyland, and hopefully completing the world. How about that? That's a short, sweet little ending. So we'll see you later, guys, and until next time. You know what killed the dinosaurs? The Ice Age! Okay, but anyway, hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. And we gotta trek across this tightly. Oh, God! Oh, no! Oh, God! Oh, God! Oh, no! Try that again. Oh God, that's a blooper. That's gonna be the end right there.